Hello everyone, my name is Teriprasem and welcome back to Stories, The Path of Destinies. Now, as you probably seen from my last two videos, I had some issues with that last video, so apologies about that. Everything else from this point forward should be completely okay. And, well, let's just start. Since we so far revealed all of these truths, I'm thinking follow those truths and see where they lead us.
The clouds parted over the Isles of Boreas. It was time to choose. The rebellion was in trouble. Ravens were scouting for the secret rebel base. They needed a game changer. Pieces of the Sky Ripper had surfaced. Renata knew that using it could go catastrophically wrong, but he was sure he could figure out how to use it safely. Also, a temple had risen out of empty desert. The Iblis Stone was hidden there. It was a dangerous artifact. It could corrupt its user into a bloodthirsty monster. Maybe he could find a way to use it, to take its power without surrendering to its wickedness. And also, his old friend Lupino needed rescuing. Of course,
who ended up being
Renato had
traitor.
A pretty strong suspicion that Lupino had betrayed the rebellion. And he had a gut feeling that he needed to use that to his advantage.
So let's see. Yeah, that text hasn't still changed.
Renato finally realized that Lupino was a traitor to the cause, and maybe Renato could use that somehow.
Oh yes, we are heading this way. So, Renato could use that somehow. What to do with the knowledge about Lupino's treason? Renato would be foolish to trust Lupino again. He should confront him, or better yet, find a way to use the traitor against his new master, the Emperor. Maybe Lupino could be a game changer after all.
Renato couldn't quite put his paw on when he'd realized Lupino was working for the Empire. He'd never exactly seen Lupino sending coded messages to the palace, but he was sure. The rabbit had been on too many disastrous missions where he was the only survivor, or where he accidentally missed getting on the boat that went down to the abyss in flames. If Renato could prevent Lupino from getting back to the fleet with all the intelligence he'd probably gathered, it might be worth the trip.
Now that you mention it, he did escape that destruction of observatory, for example. I still kind of wish that Lupino wouldn't have been the traitor.
They'd been on so many adventures together. Lupino had talked Renato out of prison at least four times, and Renato had rescued Lupino from at least two lynch mobs.
Yeah, I hate to see it this way, since it's been quite clear that these two have had quite a good history together. That was fun.
I always felt that the rabbit resented him. Lupino was hilarious because he was so down on himself and everyone else. But behind the laughs, he wasn't a happy camper. Ooh, was this payback? Or did the Empire have his little white tail in a vice?
Those both sound possible, but that the illustration in book didn't really show that. Now let's use that level up we got at the end of the last failed recording. Anyway, so let's get this storm recovery, and then hookshot dealing some damage. There we go. And open up this doorway.
Hey, what do ravens say when they die? Never mind. I'll wait.
Come back here. One way to deal with the attacking
ravens
enemies.
Ravens are landing everywhere from dropships. He'd better get moving. If they got to Lupino first, the rabbit would give the Empire all the intelligence he'd been stealing from the Rebellion, and they'd probably give him a medal. He'd have to be very careful about how he played Lupino. At the slightest hint of danger, the mad rabbit would take off like a... well, a rabbit.
Rabbit. I also
love
that...
There was still no sign of Lupino. Not a hair. Not a pellet. Was he hiding in the cemetery further down the road? That didn't seem like him.
Like, I was about to say... It's fun to finally hear something new being said during these early map parts. Down, and strike. Lots of explosions. Fun. Not literal ones, but still.
The core was dangerous. Bernardo had a fleeting idea that the two ideas went together somehow. And then it was gone again. Ah, oh, damn ideas. They never stuck around when you needed them.
That's actually quite interesting. Considering that core is poisonous. I still hate to do that to him, but is there any other solution really? I can't really think of one. I was suspecting that we would have used the Ipli Stone rather than Core first. But I guess this works too.
This could be the new aerobics craze. Am I right?
So, hello there.
Bloody and exhausted. Renato finally reached Lupino. The rabbit was practicing shuffling his favorite deck. Now that he knew what the rabbit was, there are a few things about him that Renato didn't find so amusing anymore. You sent me an urgent message saying that you're in danger.
Oh, I am. The ravens are coming. Now, I got a clever plan to kidnap Zenobia.
Renato wanted to clap shackles on the rabbit and shout, "You're a traitor, and I'm not falling for it." But if there was one thing Renato was sure of, it was that the core of the Sky River was dangerous mostly to its user. If he could put it in the Emperor's hands, old Isengrim III might blow himself and his fleet up with it. Yes, that was it.
Seems like this isn't so straightforward again, but let's stick to that core plan. Send the traitor to fetch the core. Reynardo realized how good an actor Lupino was. No surprise he has been fooled by the traitor. Maybe he could give that smug traitor the location of the Sky Ripper's core. And while Lupino delivers the unstable weapon to the enemy, Reynardo would pay Zenobia a visit.
Reynardo felt like a real hero, brave and smart. He told the rabbit all about the Sky Ripper's God's Eye core.
"I'll go get the core while you attack Zenobia," he told the rabbit.
Wait, I've an even better idea. I'll get the core, and you attack Zenobia, said the rabbit. Right, yeah, that is better, agreed Renato. Perfect. The traitor would make sure the Emperor got the core. Now Renato just needed the Emperor to use the core. If he could only get something that the Emperor wanted very badly.
And that is Zenobia.
He could save her and bait the Emperor at the same time.
Maybe. I'm still not sure how this all comes together, but it's fun to try to guess this.
Right. Now, all Renato had to do was fight his way through Zenobia's invading troops, sneak onto her ship and into her bedroom, and kidnap her without any of her dozens of guards alerting her. Then,
easy,
he would
easy.
Rely on her love for him to convince her how evil her father was. So she'd run away with him instead of going back to her father, who was going to blow himself up. It did sound a little risky. But Renato had a feeling it would work out somehow. It always did.
So we're once more back here. Convince Zenobia to switch sides. It will be surprisingly easy. At least I hope so. But on the other hand, it has been so far. Still one. Here you are.
Renato wondered if he could learn to cook this way. Probably not.
Will I miss this once again? Of course I did. Luckily, I didn't try too many times this time.
He could
now
learn
let's,
new skills.
Get this level
if only he'd
up
take
down.
The time to figure out which.
How about if we go with the. Increase damage on hooked enemies. Up you go. You too. And have a nice life. Couldn't get everyone out of here. Soon reach that the end. Let's go here this time. We've been down on sewers too many times already.
This chest smelled kind of funky. He hoped he didn't get it in his clothes.
Luckily, I don't need to kill all of these eyes. That's this one. Oh. Well, that was a failure. Let's try that again. Maybe I should actually kill all of these eyes. Come on, just when I was about to go there.
Hey, how do you tell if someone's far away? Or just really small?
that could have ended quite badly. Down you go, and there we go. Now, that's what I was supposed to do last time. And there's Lupino. I wasn't expecting to see him here.
I was halfway to Zenobia's encampment when Lupino showed up. He was disheveled and distraught.
They jumped us. I barely got away. Oh, they got the core.
Oh, it was all going according to plan, thought Renato.
Oh.
Now he just needed Zenobia on his side. Yes, that was even better. The Iblis Stone. Zenobia could get it. And then the Emperor would have to pursue them. Wait.
I'm not sure I like that.
The gem would corrupt anyone.
Yes.
Even her. That's it, he thought. Even Lupino. Even though Lupino was already a traitor, it would turn him against his secret master, the Emperor.
I thought this would...
himself Emperor. And the Emperor would have to defend himself with the core.
I was expecting this...
He was a super genius.
...to actually... to send Lupino after Iblis Stone earlier. I'm glad... that it's actually this way, done this way here.
This is terrible, Renata told the rabbit. If only I had gone for the Iblis Stone. But now it's lost in enemy territory. He handed Lupino a map. It gives the bearer so much power. We can only hope the Emperor never finds it. What was that?
Such acting!
Said Lupino. I think someone's following us. I didn't hear anything. Rabbit ears.
You go on ahead. I'll check it out.
And with that, Lupino hopped off with the map.
Exactly as planned. Now, let's go and meet Zenobia.
The lead raven.
Oh. There was that explodey one, but... I didn't think I froze him, but apparently I did! That was close. That was really close to get hit there. And let's go and meet Zenobia once more.
Renato slinked through Zenobia's ship, making no sound at all. She was curled up on her bed. He'd forgotten how beautiful she was. How sleek. How soft. He tapped her on the shoulder with his sword. She was made of smoke, and he noticed he had a very solid blade to his throat. Did you really think you could capture me? Heard a familiar voice. I just wanted to chat, said Renato. Did you ever wonder why the Emperor adopted you? He needs a sacrifice. Someone who truly loves him, to make a bargain with the lost gods.
That's a vicious lie.
He wants to bring him back. Not a lie, sweetheart.
That's crazy. Why would anyone...
They could make him immortal. An eater of souls. And with that... her eyes widened. She understood. Renato told her how he had rescued a priest whose order had been massacred. How he had slept in a burnt village. At midnight, the Emperor's victims had come to him in his dreams to tell him of the hideous eldritch rituals they'd been sacrificed in. He could still see those kittens and puppies. Their wide, sad eyes, their moist noses.
You can't prove that.
I've got a witness at the observatory.
And we are going to see once more dead scientist there. Is it been so far 3 in a row? If this time counted,
he
when we are going to
here. Why he was really here. He didn't want her to be anywhere near the fleet when her father blew himself and Lupino up. So he told her about how the Emperor's obscene rituals had raised ancient artifacts out of the land. How he'd followed the appalling trail of the hideous horrors His Majesty had perpetrated for the sake of his own immortality.
Any of this ring a bell? He said. He told me it was all lies. You've always known when I was lying. I always hated that about you, said Renardo. The rebellion had started after atrocities that the Empire hushed up. Renardo had rescued a priest whose order
we just heard for this one.
He had slept in a burnt village. Dead kittens and puppies had come to tell him what the Emperor had done to them.
I'm wondering why are they repeating that line there. And if you wonder why I'm heading here, I want to little bit of change to normal route I'm taking here. Even though it's kind of unnecessary to go here, because I can't really upgrade my weapons anymore. But still, I want to not just rush through this.
It was a bit windy up here.
There we go, and little bit of new scenery too here. At least I don't remember being here in a while. Loving these stairways. Well, that's a lot of ravens. And I was hit there first time in a long time. And there's next swinging point. Oh, let's check this. At school we learned the gospel of the transcendent emperor, the last divinity to pierce the skies. He would banish the evil old gods and grant us the gift of time. But could one man, divine as he may be, create something as intricate as time? I have my own theory. I believe that time is a symptom rather than a gift. I am convinced that on a cosmic scale there is a pendulum motion between order and chaos. The transcendent emperor ended the chaos and started the age we live in. An age of cause and effect, of fact and logic. Time is merely the tapestry upon which these laws manifest themselves. It is the foundation for order's companion, entropy. But in the age of chaos, when the old gods reign, perception carries more weight than facts. Emotions can shape the worlds, and time ceases to exist. The age of order is ending. I am merely helping the inevitable. Entropy has been broken, fate has been breached. The end of time is coming, and I shall embrace it. Emperor Isengrim III, Secret Journal. I don't remember reading that before. That was quite interesting. And back to normal route. Oh. Well, this will be a little bit awkward. Looks like I'm out of time here, so I will be ending this recording here, and I will see you next time. Goodbye!